Hello guys, welcome to another series of 2JZ Tuesday. My name is Michael Chung, and today I'm going to show you guys three throttle bodies from 2JZ, three different types, and additionally I will introduce two more popular throttle bodies that people modify them into 2JZ. The first one is the cable one. This one is together with the traction control. Okay, so this one I've already modified the internal so that it will be open up together. Alright. Okay, so this one, the throttle position sensor, I will show you guys the part number below, but actually it is all the same throughout the 2JZ NA and GTE versions. Alright, so because of this one got the traction control and I don't want this to interfere my driving, and traction control is not so predictable also, especially in high speed circuit racing, in drift application and in drag also. Okay, so even F1 drivers, they also don't use traction control into certain limit. They don't use this one to lower down the engine power to reduce the wheel spin. They use different methods instead. Alright, so this one I've already welded in internally so that this one can turn at the same time. Okay, I'm going to show you guys the other one with traction control. Okay, so in my hand I got this NA version, so you can see that this type is the NA version. Okay, so this one, if you can see carefully, this one, when I turn this one, the butterfly valve does not open, and it only opens when I turn almost 80 to the half, no, 90 to the 100%, so it will only open a little bit. You can also see from here that the throttle position sensor that I have removed, when I turn this one, no motion until it is 90%, it goes to 100%, so it only turns a little bit. So you try to make some modifications so that it will turn 100% fully. Okay, so when you turn 100%, it will open fully. Okay, so what does this do is, when you accelerate too much, okay, when the ECU detects there is a wheel slipping on either of your tires, then they will reduce the engine torque by reducing your throttle body position. So it will try to move your butterfly valve and reduce the air from coming in. So you can feel your engine will be revving lower so that you have lesser wheel spin. Okay, but in drift or in F1, we don't want 100% traction control because we want to be fast, right? Alright, so okay, I'm going to show you guys a little bit more later. Smoke weed every day. Okay, so I got another one. This one is a little bit more fun. Okay, so what does this do is, this one is originally open, so when it sense got any traction slippage, this one will close by itself. Okay, so here there is one butterfly valve, but inside there is also another butterfly valve. If you can see carefully, can you see this? It's jammed. Okay, it is around here. Okay, so what does this do is, this one can reduce the butterfly valve. So even if you full throttle, but this one you will try to reduce your air intake. Alright, and then this one is quite fun also, because there is one more this one 6-pin using a pulse width modulation to control the idle air. Okay, this one is using 6 wires. Okay, but if you guys notice that the previous throttle body, they don't have the idle valve anywhere. I mean, they have their own idle air control at the intake manifold. Okay, so it will allow air to come in to increase your idle, especially when you turn on your aircon or you turn on your lights or you add a bit of load into your idle, or you just want to add more idle. So they just add one idle air control valve somewhere in the intake, okay, for this type of throttle body. But for this type, it is quite easy, okay. If you got more load, you just turn on your aircon or you turn on your front lights. As long as you want to increase your idle, you just need to tell the computer to do so. Alright guys, I hope you guys learn something from here. I'm going to show two more very fun throttle bodies that people modify to their 2J engine or to any engines. Okay, the first one is VQ45 throttle body. Alright, this one is from Nissan. The throttle body, this one is very big. Okay, it is about 85 mm diameter. So this one is very big. This one can allow more airflow, more boost, and therefore you can put more fuel in, you can make more power. Okay, but still this one is drive by a normal cable. Alright, this one comes with two sockets, but if I'm not mistaken, you just need to use one of them. Alright, to just go to your standalone ECU, so they will understand. And if you want to adjust your throttle position, just need to unscrew this one, release it, and adjust this one. Okay, so this one is very simple. Okay, I'm going to show you guys one more. This one is I'm going to use it for my next project. This one I'm going to use for my next 2JZ project. Okay, so you can see that this one is very small. It is only about 76 mm of diameter. This one I'm using a Nissan Sentra or Primera or Nissan Fair Lady 370Z. The part number should be the same, okay? But although this one is small, this one is drive by wire. Okay, what does it mean drive by wire? It does not have a cable movement, okay? All of this movement is controlled by the electric motor here, a stepper motor here, okay? This one stepper motor is controlled by 6 wires also. This one is also used pulse width modulation from the ECU. If you are using a standalone ECU, you can directly control the butterfly valve of this throttle body. So why did I make the decision of using this throttle body is, I want to use the standalone ECU to control everything including the idle too. Alright? Okay. What I can do from here is, I can control idle if I turn on the lights. Okay, then when I turn on the lights, they will give an input signal to the computer, and then the computer will raise this idle, that means open up the butterfly valve just a little bit, so that it will increase the RPM a little bit and adding some charges from the alternator back to your lights, or when I turn on my aircon. Alright, so this is a very big dilemma, because drifters or racers like us, we hate and we love aircon at the same time. We hate it because it is very heavy, okay, it takes up some power from your engine, but actually we love it during hot days, okay. When we are melting in the car, while we are waiting for nothing, we just turn on the aircon and we happily enjoy the aircon so that we can relax our mind too. Alright, and then second thing is very important is regarding about safety too. You know, aircon and safety. Actually, when there is a heavy rain, fogging will occur inside your windscreen. So this one makes you cannot see outside. So you need to wipe, or you need to defog it, or you need to put whatever solution to make it one condensed water. So this one is very troublesome. Why not just turn on your aircon? Right now, especially for drift, after we finish one lap, especially in raining, we just turn on our aircon. The driver inside can relax, and then all the windscreen will be defogged. Why not do that? Okay, and then one more advantage of using aircon is just for our low level of 2JZ modification is we use the belting for the whole original setup. Okay, we don't bypass the aircon. If we bypass the aircon, a lot of friends, they experience the same thing, which is the belt fly. When the belt fly, okay, there is no water pump, it's okay. Maybe the alternator is not charging, it's okay. But most importantly is the power steering pump suddenly is not working. Your power steering suddenly not working, so you feel very hard to turn. So it may cause crash, okay? I got a friend, Charles Ng, who had a crash in Elite Speedway because his 2JZ engine, the belt fly. So I don't want to take this as an example, but I mean we all can learn from each other's mistake, you see. So I got a lot of mistakes, so I hope you guys learn from my mistakes so you guys won't commit the same mistakes, right? So I hope you guys to if you guys got any mistakes, feel free to comment below so that you can share with the community too. Alright, so back to this drive-by-wire throttle body. The secondary reason is I want to put anti-lag system for this 2JZ. Okay, I want to try this one in my new 2JZ. So anti-lag, what does anti-lag do is, especially for people like us, we use big turbo. Alright, so when big turbo, it comes with big turbine, that means very lag. Alright, lag means you need to rev up to high RPM so that the turbo have enough boost to spool up. Okay, so when drifters like us, we drifters or racers, when we throttle and when we lift off our throttle, the RPM will drop. When the RPM drop, the turbo will receive lesser exhaust gas, and therefore it requires time to boost up, to spool up. Alright, so this one is called turbo lag. So how to reduce it from this anti-lag system is, when I release my throttle, okay, I'm going to set a few conditions that I'm going to show you guys in the next few videos. I'm going to set a few conditions so that when I lift off my throttle, it's supposed to be closed, but it stays open, so allows more air to go in. Allows more air to go in so that the engine will continue to rev a bit. But most importantly is to ask the ECU to retard the timing. The retard the timing means you ignite the spark plug after top dead center. Alright, so what does it do is it will make very hot exhaust gases and continue to blow your turbo. This will make your turbo lesser lag. So this is what I want to try. Of course, it is detrimental to your engine, your exhaust valve, your turbo, your exhaust manifold. But at what cost? We just try to win at any cost, right? Okay, so I hope you guys learn something from this video, and I hope you guys to press the subscribe button if you guys would like to learn more from 2JZ Tuesday. See you!